So good evening, folks. As promised, I am sending you some discussion on the case studies. I have been traveling since morning 6:30, gone to Pune to conduct a viva. So really no time to write. So I thought I'd make a big video and send it across. Let me first read out the first question that came in 2016. Very quickly, I'm sure you already have the question with you. Risibly yours was crafted to build awareness of basmati variants of Fortune Foods, for which the brand chose content marketing strategy driven through a portal. The idea was to ask people what is their signature dish or dish they are known for and tell them which type of basmati will work for them or work will go well with it. The brand teamed up with Chef Pranav Joshi, who would visit the lucky people to taste their signature dish at their home, while the portal housed interesting videos and facts about basmati rice. Social media channels were used to drive traffic to the site. Through digital media, Fortune Foods intends to spread the word with engaging visuals. Now the questions were, what are the key advertising objectives to promote the campaign? How would you use Facebook as a platform to promote the campaign? How would you use Twitter as a medium to promote the campaign? This was the question that was in 2016 or 17. Now, let's take on the first question. What are the key advertising objectives? The key advertising objectives is obviously they want to promote their rice, different types of basmati rice. But the objective of this particular campaign is to drive people to their website. Alright, that is what they wanted to do here. Look at what is written here. The content marketing strategy was driven through a portal, which means the content was on the portal and people were asked to go to the portal to know about basmati rice. It was more of an awareness campaign. It was not direct selling. Remember one thing, in digital marketing, it is very tacky to directly sell. You can't just say, okay, buy this pen. You need to drive people to some content, to some scheme, to some, strategic location or your landing page where you place content which will in turn ask people or encourage people to go and buy a product. You don't do direct selling. The advertising in digital media is subtle a lot of times. And it is marketing and not sales. You should always remember that. So what are the key advertising objectives to promote this campaign? We have already talked about it. So one is to promote their rice, to drive traffic to the portal where they get more and more, they can show people the content. And in turn, people will, they hope that people will go and buy their basmati variants. The other thing was to drive people to the Facebook page through which they will be showing interesting videos. Now, what they have done, two things. Even yesterday when we were discussing on, or the day before yesterday when we were discussing on BMM Bawal, I told you that a lot of it, a lot of the strategy would involve offline strategies also rather than online. Because people love to take part in events, people love to take part in activities. So an event organized along with your online activity or an activity on organized even along with an event online is how you should always plan your strategy ideally, right? It all depends on what you are trying to do though on that. So what they did, they hired or teamed up with Pranav Joshi. So it is Pranav Joshi being a master chef, and imagine him visiting your household and you feeling so good about it, and the company making videos out of it, promoting you, promoting the fact that such a big chef is visiting their homes, people's homes. That works. That makes the campaign viral. And once it gets viral, people through that campaign visit. So they made videos, they must have posted them on YouTube. And now let us look at how would Facebook platform be used to promote the company. Okay, now one very important thing, they need to have a page. So I suppose they didn't have a page to promote their campaign. On the page, you post those videos, or you post a link of your YouTube video on your page. Both works, because when you post a YouTube link, automatically you get the video image on Facebook. So in that way, what happens is you have a Facebook post, which in turn drives traffic to your YouTube post. From YouTube post, if you have proper content, proper tags, then you can drive your traffic from YouTube post to your website. At the same time, from Facebook post, you can drive people to your website. All this works in tandem with each other. So what will I do on Facebook? I'll create a page, I'll post my videos there. I also start tagging people, tagging individuals, tagging other groups, tagging chefs, tagging people who register themselves on this. So probably they must have used Riceably yours as a campaign and advertised it in other media, advertised it in Twitter maybe. We are going to that again. So create a hashtag, right? Popularize it. So I'm sure there must have been some kind of television ad which popularized the hashtag and the campaign. So you can always say when Pranav Joshi visit you. In Facebook, you can target specific audiences. Understand that when you create an ad in Facebook, when you post a video and you say that this is good, you go to Ads Manager in Facebook. From Ad Manager, you create the ad. Don't just post the ad and boost it. It is better to go to the Ads Manager and then create an ad from there, because you get a lot of parameters that you can choose from. You can choose the age group to which you are targeting. You can choose the gender. Now what with the gender here? You will probably first be targeting housewives, right? Because they are the ones who will be interested in getting a Pranav Joshi their home, because they are the ones who cook ultimately. A working woman may or may not find the time. So Pranav Joshi may not find the time to visit their homes in late evenings, or very early in the morning, some woman doesn't have a time to cook elaborate dishes with basmati rice. So the target group will be very clear. So you'll have an age group, you'll have a gender. You can also target localities. You can target the whole of country, you can target the whole of state, you can target the whole of city or pockets in the city. So I can for my institute, MET Institute of Transportation, I can target just Bandra, I can target just pockets where I think I'll get my audiences, or I can target the whole of Mumbai, or I can target specific cities. So when we do digital marketing, we do all these for different campaigns, right? So one a video ad may be targeted towards just Mumbai city. Another video ad may be targeted towards specific cities across the country. I may also want to try to promote students from international students. So I may target some specific countries and the cities abroad, because we know a lot of people from Nigeria, Kenya, even the Gulf do come and study here. So okay, I'm diverting. So how would you use Twitter as a medium? Hashtags, of course, right? You use hashtags, you popularize the hashtag. And there is a unsaid rule that when you're doing a Twitter campaign, you need at least 10 tweets per day, right? You may repeat one or two, but you can't repeat all. 10 tweets per day, talking about basmati, talking about basmati variants, talking about your Fortune Foods, everywhere, using the hashtag that you're trying to promote, right? And then just keep on tweeting. So you need to make it as interesting as possible. Luckily now Twitter has allowed us 280 characters instead of 140 today. So you have a better opportunity to write something which is more legible. Remember one thing when in digital marketing, do not use GR8 and WTF in your text. Complete words are the ones that work. So if you want to give a link to some page, if you want to give a link to a YouTube video, use bit.ly, bit.ly. There you can reduce the size of your link, and from a elaborate link you can get a small link that you can use that saves space, especially in terms of Twitter, right? 280 characters mein sab kuch likhna hai. So that's how I would deal with this particular campaign. Anything more, I don't know. So you are driving traffic to the site through social media. That's the campaign. And this is how I would answer the question here at least. Let me also, if you have the app with you, then you will know that I have posted a lot of case studies. Let's go through a couple of case studies and treat it exactly the way we are treating this particular case study. That will give you a better idea of how to think about this particular question, right? So let's say I personally found this very interesting, so I'm taking this up. The Quora content marketing case study by Bajaj FinServ. I talked about this. What was the target group? The target group was people who would like to invest, people who would like to take a loan from Bajaj FinServ. So you know the kind of target group. You will, if you are talking of home loans, you'll probably see a target people who are a little young, who are in need of a house. Generally, people with my age, white hair, do not go for a house, a new loan at this stage, at this age. But a younger crowd does generally. So the crowd, the target group, first identify the target group, right? So that be the target group generally for home loans. For vehicle loan, yes, maybe I might be interested in buying a new vehicle. So maybe I might be a target group for vehicle loans. Consumer durables, anybody can be targeted. So you need to first identify what you want to start a campaign for. Once you decide your campaign, then you start with the challenge. How are you going to do it, right? So this particular one, the data content marketing. Content marketing is placing content with a lot of data, with a lot of useful information that the consumer will use, and through that you drive traffic either to your website or drive traffic to your organization and whatever you're trying to sell, right? So what they did was very innovative. I don't know whether you people are using Quora to ask questions about your career, about courses that you can do after graduation, etc., etc. But Quora is a very good platform for knowing things, because a lot of experts are registered in Quora. A lot of people who know about things in their own field are registered on Quora, and they do answer your question. I also am registered and I answer questions on media and courses in media, etc., etc., and careers in media. But what they did was they identified Quora as the platform where they can use it for question answers, the Q&A platform, and they created two characters, right? I talked about it in the live video that we did. They identified two characters. What were the names of the characters? Arvind Sharma and Anamika Verma, right? These are the two characters. They were already employees of Bajaj FinServ. But what they did was they disconnected these two people as employees of Bajaj FinServ. They created the identity on Quora in such a way that they are known as experts in finance, right? So when they answered questions by people, they only answered as experts in finance with no direct connection to Bajaj FinServ. So while answering those questions, they let through, hints, or maybe that Bajaj FinServ is the one which will probably the best place to go for these kind of loans. And that means they created influencers on Quora, right? Instead of what we are looking at influencers today is generally influencers on Instagram. But these people created influencers in Quora, and they actually did a fantastic job. The total number of views was 1,64,000, 14,244. They had profile views. It witnessed a growth of 120%, etc., etc. And it was a major, major success. Okay, let me go to one more. I'm talking of enterprise. Now this is an SEO campaign, okay? So SEO campaign means you are going to work hard on the SEO part of it, search engine optimization part of it, because it's quite possible that you are not having a good rank on your search engine page. and it's useless to have your site listed in the second or third page, because nobody bothers. You first see the first 10 and you're finished with your search, generally speaking, right? Unless you're searching for something very specific. So what problem did Airtel have? Airtel had very poor visibility. The first, they wanted their link to be in the first three search engine ranking, right? So that low ranking was actually bothering them a lot. What it did? What was the target? Target was not any specific. It was not a specific target in terms of audiences, but it was about reach of the people. Okay, I'll also divert a little bit. When you are looking at any digital marketing strategy, there's one thing that I've left out in the app is understanding insights, analyzing the results of your campaign. Never ever fall in love with your campaign, because it's quite possible that it is not working. Discard it, redesign it, re-implement it. That is very important. So that is, of course, when you start doing actual campaigns online. So what they did, they targeted specific keywords. They actually made a list of 2,000 keywords that could help users connect with Airtel website, right? 2,000 keywords. And what was the four products that they targeted? Postpaid, prepaid, broadband, and DTH services. These are the four products they targeted. 4,000 keywords, and they started buying those keywords, or the bidding for those keywords heavily. And after the campaign was done, the target was 440 cities across the country. So that's what I'm saying. It was not a very specific audience they targeted. They wanted reach. So this campaign was about reaching more and more people through SEO optimization, right? So when you search for broadband, you need to have Airtel on top. When you search for postpaid, you need to have Airtel on top, and not Vodafone or not Idea. That was the campaign. Again, a major success. They were able to get the first three position for all three products. It's cause marketing, right? So how do you get clients? How do you get consumers? How do you catch hold of consumers? How do you make consumers think of your brand? What is the objective behind any digital marketing strategy or any marketing strategy? It is about how people will identify with your brand when they think of something, right? So the ways and means to do are several. In fact, in one of the articles that I've read, there are 7,000 different ways by which you can target audiences. Now, obviously, we cannot do all that, but yes, you should always think of how you can enhance the or how you can make the brand more visible, not in terms of visibility on media, but how to make the brands more recallable by the client when they think of anything. So let's see this particular campaign, Tata Tika. They made a cause marketing study. What they did, so okay, there's a lot of what is Tata, etc. So they launched this Jagore campaign, right? It was launched in 2007. Transforming a humble cup of tea to a symbol of social awakening. So Jagore became a wake-up call for the society, right? It worked. If you remember the campaign, Thanda Matlab Coca-Cola, or several such campaigns, Jagore was one of those campaigns which actually, you know, gave a lot of good feeling to the clients when they saw this particular ad. Just the way, if you remember Hamara Bajaj campaign, that also gave a kind of feeling, you know, that is very important. So I start identifying with a brand when I think of something. So patriotism, for example, Tata Namak, Desh Ka Namak. So Namak, Desh, Tata, understand, that's the kind of campaign. Now imagine running that was long time back. Now imagine running that campaign online. You can think of several ways of doing it. So Jagore campaign was very, very successful. The key focus areas of Jagore campaign was to establish a stronger connection between Tata Tea and Jagore in the minds of people, get people to engage with Tata Tea, position Tata Tea as a thought leader, right? These are the main objectives, and the hard-hitting campaign did pay off, all right? So all in all, when you're thinking of these campaigns, when you get a question in your question paper, what are you going to do is first see how, what kind of campaign has the organization run, whether it was a content marketing strategy or campaign, was it was cause marketing, whether it was to you know, enhance the SERP, search engine ranking page, so SEO strategy, SEO search engine marketing strategy. When you think of search marketing, you should first think of paying the search engine to get an ad on top. All right, search engine optimization is essentially getting a rank by optimizing the website and getting organic ranking. Search engine marketing is getting paid ranking. Please understand the difference between the two. So was it about search engine optimization? Was it about reach of the audiences? Was it a combination of offline and online activities? These are the kind of things you should study. When you get the question paper in your hand, please study the question thoroughly. See, first see what was the objective. Second, see what was the target audiences. Third, see what was the main objective. Was it the product? Was it the cause? What is the product to the cause? You just first jot down all these things on the rough side of your answer sheet. So objectives, target audiences, and the kind of campaign that is being run. Once you are through with that, then you are going to think about which strategy to use. It's Facebook, right? There are two ways to do it. One is post pictures, post videos, post just text with images, right? That you do only for organic part of it, right? So if you are able to create good hashtags, if you are able to tag a lot of people, if you have them on your list, right, your friends list, you need to have a lot of likes, you need to have a lot of people following you, then you can tag a lot of people, that will help you get organic likes. Then you boost the campaign, or you boost the ad, or directly, ideally when you want to pay money to Facebook, ideally go to the ads manager. So ads manager.facebook.com, I think is the link, I don't remember the exact syntax, but you create the ad from there. You can target audiences, you can target likes, or I forgot to mention that you can target the area, the age group, the gender, the likes and dislikes, the educational qualification, the maybe the income group. You can target children, and you can target parents of children. You can target people who like certain kind of things. You can also target people who don't like certain. There are a lot of options available once you enter that phase, right? Second, you can also schedule your ad. You can also schedule. So it is not necessary that you always post it immediately and get published. You can always schedule your ads properly. For example, they say in India, I have read some articles to which I am taking. My experience is slightly different, but generally in India, you can target Facebook at about 1 to 3 p.m. is the time when you add Facebook ads. It works better, but I found that Facebook also works very good when you target it at 7 o'clock in the morning when people start traveling to offices, and the evening when people are going back home. These three timings are very good for Facebook. A lot of people say Tuesdays are very bad, but I don't think so. All days are quite good. On Sundays though, always target the time at 1 o'clock, right, in the afternoon. 1 to 3 is the best time to target in on Sunday afternoons. So a lot of, you get a lot of articles and you get a lot of suggestions for this. Similarly, Twitter, you need to tweet at least 10 times a day. Create hashtags, popularize hashtag, piggyback on some popular hashtags. Don't overdo it, otherwise people will laugh at you, right? On Twitter also, you can promote your Facebook page, you can promote your YouTube also, anything. So, and promote your website, of course. Once you do that, look at your own website or the organization's website. Understand how the website is working. Is it responsive? It is mobile friendly or not? Then you also look at the SEO that is being done for the website. Is it good enough? Does it have good meta tags? Does it have keywords inbuilt into the text that is there in the website and not appearing like these are my keywords 1 2 3 4 5. No, they should be a part of the story. They should not stand out as keywords. They should be, they should flow very gently and very easily as a part of the text. Only then it works, right? It should not stand out. So look at the SEO part of it, then think of SEM if necessary. I'm just giving you all that you can do. You can choose whatever is fit for that particular campaign. Then go to Google AdWords, understand that, go to Google Trends, find out which AdWords are working, which are not working, which are having the maximum hits. Pay Google for those AdWords, pay Facebook. Facebook you can pay a little amount to get a lot of reach, of course. There are a lot of things that I can't really explain to right now, but there's something called reach, means how many people that is reached. There's something called impressions, means how many people are actually been able to get it on their screens and seen on their screens. There are clicks, means how many people have clicked the video or ad or whatever you have given. All the, there are something called link clicks. So if you have given a link in the ad, how many people have link clicked on the link and gone to your web page. All these things are important. If you are doing with something very specific, a cause or a product, you can also create something called a landing page on your website and drive traffic to the landing page. Because suppose you come, you are searching for a digital marketing course and I give you a link and it goes to our main website where all courses are listed, but you are interested only in digital marketing. Why make you read all that? Instead, I would rather directly direct you to the digital marketing website page. So if you are specifically marketing digital marketing course, I would take you directly to digital marketing special page called landing page that is made where you get the necessary information. So this is how you start, you know, working out with the strategy. Then always think of mobiles. Please don't forget mobile phones. Understand geo tagging. Read up. You still have time, say 12 hours to work on. Read up geo tagging. Read up geo fencing. Read up what kind of banner ads. It's there in one of the chapters in the app. Read up some of the banner ads. What is an interstitial ad? What is a banner ad which appears in the top? How to place them? How the banner ad can be embedded into the story? All these things understand. Third, always think of integration. So you paste, you post something on Facebook. You can take the link and post it on Twitter. So your link, your Twitter and Facebook are linked. Whenever you place an ad on Facebook, it automatically appears on your Instagram page. So you need to have an Instagram account also, which is again a business account, right? You should go to Instagram, register as a business account, then link these two accounts. It's very easily possible. Just go to the settings of each one of them and link them together. So when you post as an ad, it automatically goes to your Instagram. You can click and say go to my Instagram account also. That is when the ad should appear there also. So you link all these things. So you post a video on YouTube, right? Give a link of that in the post that you post on Facebook. When you, if you use it as an ad, it appears on Instagram. Then take the YouTube link, post it on Twitter with hashtags, etc. So you're linking the four main social media platforms that are being used and keep doing it every time. Flood it. Of course, don't overdo it. You run it, you run a campaign for a specific period of time only. So design the time period on which the campaign is going to be run. Is it a 1 month long campaign? Is it a 3 month long campaign? What is your objective? I talked about one thing yesterday that if your target is a grocery shop, right? If your target is a grocery shop, then what you'll use online as well as offline method. If you read the case studies or examples that are given in the app, you'll see there's one example that given up for local florist. Suppose I want to do digital marketing for a local florist, a florist who has got a little better kind of shop, but not a tapri wala on the roadside. But what would I do for digital marketing? Think different, right? So like I gave an example in the we saw some examples previously, there would be an offline as well as online activity. what will I start doing is I will design something online as well as offline. So maybe I can start off with distributing flowers to old people who are visiting the local church, right? Distributing flowers, just standing in outside the local temple and giving one flower to each of the devotees who come to the temple, right? I will also maybe start sending in handbills and pamphlets across the area with through the local newspaper wala. Another thing that we can do, a lot of things that can be done online. I need to start a PR campaign. So once somebody buys flowers from me, I'll give them a chota sa form, take the details. So get their name, email ID and mobile numbers. I need to build a customer base. I need to build a database to whom you can send information. So once they have given me that, I'll start building up a mailing list. Email marketing is also a very important thing that you need to understand and not forget when you're writing your answer. Maybe it'll be one of the parts that you can use. Create an email list, use something like MailChimp to send emails, automated replies, and somebody wants to opt out, they can easily opt out by just saying opt out or unsubscribe. The mailing list automatically deletes them from the list, so you don't spam people, right? Maybe you can create WhatsApp groups. Maybe you can start sending people, start wishing people on their birthdays, start wishing people on festivals. All this can be done online, right? So understand that you can also pay Google to have a location specific ad space. So if somebody searches for a florist in Borivali, your name should come first because you're paid Google. You can also use geotagging. So if somebody has reached your area and searches for florist, yours is the first name they'll get because you have paid for the geotagging. That means you have paid for anyone comes there, asks for a florist, they get your shop first. There will be of course competitors, right? So use geotagging for this. Use geotagging. Another very good example is the Bose headphone example that is there in the mobile marketing section in the app. Just go through it once, right? So for a florist, I'll use offline as well as online. I'll do the PR through distributing flowers, across to people, old people. I can give freebies. I can put handbills in the newspapers. I can always advertise on the hoardings, etc., etc. I can also maybe sponsor some small events. Maybe an important person is getting married, or maybe some function a society has. I can actually sponsor the floral decoration that happens. It increases my visibility. Good PR for me, right? Along with that, suppose I have sponsored flowers for a function, right? What prevents me from taking photographs and putting it there on my Facebook page and boosting it with a specific area? See, I am a local florist. I don't need to sell flowers in Kashmir. I need to sell flowers in the area where I live, Borivali IC Colony. So what will I do? I'll target a specific area and boost those photographs and target the specific area here. So everybody hopefully will be able to see my posts and they know, this guy is there. So use local geolocation marketing. These are the kind of ways you can do digital marketing. It is not always true that you should only do something on Instagram or Twitter or Facebook. If you do a combination, that works better. Think of the example that we just dissected about Pranav Joshi going to houses. Isn't that an offline activity? But when he goes to the houses, I shoot a video and I put it on YouTube, I put it on Facebook, and I boost those posts, I boost YouTube videos, I boost Facebook posts, reaches out so many people. So many people become aware, and when so many people become aware, they also want to take part in that contest. So I register. Once I register, so what happens now? I have registered with the florist. So I'm the florist. I've got your data. I've got your email ID. I've got your mobile phone number. I've got your name. I've got your address. Now I'm free now to send you communication. I can send you emails. That is email marketing. Don't forget that. I can also send make a WhatsApp group and send greetings to a lot of people on their birthdays and not other group, of course. And I can send greetings on festivals, etc. The point is that I need to be able to grab hold of a customer and not let go. One way or another, I need to keep them engaged with me all the time. I am not looking at market shares anymore. I am looking at wallet shares. How much are you going to spend in my shop? How much are you going to spend on my product? That is what is working nowadays. I am selling experiences. I am not selling products at all. When I do digital marketing, I am not selling a product. I am selling a cause, I am selling content, I am using SEO strategies, a lot of things. So please think of all these things that are available to you. Use or write in your on your answer only the ones that are aptly that are apt to be used for that particular campaign. You have to think of campaigns. You should not think of product only. It is not sales, it is marketing. So your audience, you should understand audience, objective, the tools that you use for the campaign, and then of course always think of analysis, right? When it's getting late, I'm sorry, I was rather late today. I was traveling to Pune, so since 6:30 I've been traveling, just reached home. Yet I hope this particular session video will be useful to you for your first question tomorrow. Just before going, one thing, please start thinking of what you want to do after graduation. Do you want to go for a job or internship, or do you want to go for courses or PG courses in media? For any help, you can always contact me. My phone number is scrolling right now on this video. You can always come to my institute where I am the director, MET Institute of Mass Media. You can, I can guide you in your career. I can guide you in the courses that you could do, right? We have four postgraduate courses with 75% practical component, not the other way around that you have in BMM. So anyway, all the best for your examination. Have a great time. Bye-bye.